Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in the previous video, we learned about the logic gates. And we have also seen that when we combine these different logic gates, then it is also performed to various logic operations. So these logic operations, which is performed by this circuit, can be represented using the Boolean expressions. Or other way around, if we have some Boolean expression, then it can also be implemented using these logic gates. So in digital electronics, when we are using these logic gates, then actually we are also dealing with these Boolean expressions. And therefore, it is good to know about some Boolean laws, because using these Boolean laws, it is possible to minimize the Boolean expressions. And if we can reduce the Boolean expression, then the number of gates which is required to implement that expression will also reduce. For example, if we know the Boolean algebra, then this Boolean expression is equivalent to A plus BC. So that is why it is good to know about the Boolean laws. So here is the list of some Boolean laws. So most of them are pretty straightforward to understand. And all these laws can be proved using the truth table. So one by one, let us understand them. So first one is, this A dot 0 is equal to 0. That means the AND operation of this A and 0 is equal to 0. So we already know about the two input AND gate. And here is the truth table of the two input AND gate. So as we know, for the AND gate, when one of the input is 0, then the output is also 0. So in this case, this input B is equal to 0. So in this case, since one of the input is always 0, so output will also become 0. That means the AND operation of this A and 0 is equal to 0. Then the second is, this A dot 1 is equal to A. That means when we do the AND operation of this A and the logic 1, then the output is equal to A. So it is quite similar to our normal algebra. But to understand it more clearly, once again let us see the truth table of the AND gate. So in this case, one of the input is always set to 1. So here, for the second input A, we have only two possibilities. So when A is equal to 0, then the output of this AND gate is equal to 0. And when A is equal to 1, then the both inputs are 1. That means in that case, the output will be equal to 1. So as you can see, this Y column is same as the A. And therefore, we can say that this A dot 1 is equal to A. Then the next is, the AND operation of A and A is equal to A. That means during the AND operation, when both inputs are same, then the output is same as the input. So this is the truth table of the two input AND gate. And whenever both inputs are same, then this B is also equal to A. So in this case, for the input A, there are two possibilities. So when this A is equal to 0, then both inputs are 0. And in that case, the output of the AND gate will be equal to 0. And when A is equal to 1, then the both inputs are 1. Therefore, the output of the AND gate will be equal to 1. So as you can see, this output Y is following the input. That means this Y is equal to A. And this is also true when there are more than two inputs. For example, if we have a A dot A dot A, then that is also equal to A. Then the next is, the AND operation of the A and the A bar is equal to 0, where this A bar is the complement of the A. So to prove that, once again let us see the truth table of the AND gate. So in this case, the second input B is equal to A bar. So once again, for the input A, there are two possibilities. That means whenever this A is 0, then this A bar will be equal to 1. And similarly, when this A is 1, then this A bar is equal to 0, because this A bar is the complement of the A. So as you can see, in any case, one of the input of the AND gate is always 0. And therefore, the output of the AND gate will always remain 0. That means this Y is equal to 0. And that is why the AND operation of this A and A bar is equal to 0. So these were some of the Boolean laws related to AND operation. Similarly, let us see the Boolean laws related to OR operation. So the first is, the A plus 0 is equal to A. That means the OR operation of the A and logic 0 is equal to A. And this expression is quite similar to our normal algebra. So to prove that, once again let us see the truth table of the two input OR gate. So for the OR operation, we know that when one of the input is 1, then the output is always equal to 1. And when both inputs are 0, then only the output of the OR gate is equal to 0. So here, one of the input is always set to 0. So now for the input A, there are only two possibilities. So when this A is equal to 0, then both inputs are 0. And in that case, this output Y is equal to 0. And when this A is equal to 1, then the output of this OR gate will be equal to 1. So as you can see, this output Y is same as the A. So we can say that this Y is equal to A. That means this A plus 0 is equal to A. Then the next is the A plus 1 is equal to 1. That means the OR operation of the A and the logic 1 is always equal to 1. So once again, to prove that, let us see the truth table of the two input OR gate. So in this case, one of the input is always set to 1. So for the OR gate, we know that when one of the input is 1, then the output is always equal to 1. And therefore, irrespective of the value of A, the output Y will always remain 1. That means this A plus 1 is equal to 1. Then the next is the A plus A is equal to A. That means during the OR operation, if the both inputs are same, then the output is same as the input. And it is even valid for more than two inputs. So to prove that, once again, let us see the truth table of the two input OR gate. So in this case, this B is also equal to A. So here, for the input A, there are only two possibilities. So when the input A is 0, then the both inputs are 0. And in that case, this output Y is equal to 0. And when the input A is equal to 1, then the both inputs are 1. And in that case, this output Y is equal to 1. So as you can see, the output Y is same as the input A. And therefore, this Y is equal to A. That means this A plus A is equal to A. And as I said, it is also valid even for more than two inputs. That means if we have this A plus A plus A, then that is also equal to A. Then the next is this A plus A bar is equal to 1. That means the OR operation of the A with its complement is equal to 1. So once again, to prove this expression, let us see the truth table of the two input OR gate. So in this case, the second input is equal to A bar, that is the complement of the input A. So here, for the input A, there are only two possibilities. So when the A is 0, then this A bar is equal to 1. And whenever this A is 1, then the A bar is equal to 0. So in both cases, at least one input is 1. And we know that for the OR gate, when one of the input is 1, then the output will be equal to 1. That means in both cases, this output Y is equal to 1. And therefore, we can say that for this expression, this Y is equal to 1. Then the next is the commutative law, which says that the order in which the inputs are connected to the AND gate doesn't matter. For example, if we connect this input B at the top, and this A is connected to the bottom, then also we will get the same result. That means this A dot B is same as the B dot A. And the same is true for the OR gate. That means if B is connected at the top and the A is connected at the bottom, then also the output of the OR gate will remain same. So that is the commutative law. Then the next is the associative law. So as per this law, the AND operation of the A and B followed by the C is same as the AND operation of the B and C with the A. So let's say the A and B is ANDed first and then the output is ANDed with the C. Let's say this output is equal to Y. Now we will get the same result if B and C is ANDed first and then its output is ANDed with the A. That means the AND operation of the A and B with the C is same as the AND operation of the B and C with the A. And this can be proved with the help of the truth table. So let's say the output of this A and B is equal to P and the output of this B and C is equal to Q. So this P will be high when the both inputs A and B are high. So now these P and C are ANDed. So its output will be high when both P and C are high. And that is happening only in the last possibility. So this is the output column Y. Similarly, now let us find the Y for the second circuit. And first, let us find this Q. So this Q is high when both B and C inputs are high. So now this Q is ANDed with the A. And once again, the AND operation of the A and Q is high when both inputs A and Q are high. And that is happening only in the last possibility. So for the second circuit also, this output column Y remains same, which proves that both the expressions are same. Similarly, this associative law is also valid for the OR gate. That means the A or B OR with the C is same as the B or C OR with the A. And it can be also proved with the help of the truth table. So let's say the output of this A or B is equal to P and the output of this B or C is equal to Q. So now this P is equal to 0 when both inputs A and B are 0. Otherwise, it is equal to 1. Now this P is odd with the C. So once again, this output Y is equal to 0 when both inputs P and C are 0. Otherwise, this output Y is equal to 1. So this is the output column Y. Similarly, let us evaluate this Q for the second circuit. So as you can see, this Q is the AND operation of this B and C. That means this Q is high when both inputs B and C are high. And it is 0 when both inputs B and C are 0. Now this Q is OR with the A and its output is equal to Y. So this output Y is equal to 0 when both inputs A and Q are 0. And when any of the input is high, then the output Y is equal to high. So as you can see, for the both expressions or for the both circuits, this Y column is same, which proves that both these expressions are same. So that is the associative law for the AND and the OR operation. Similarly, it is also true for the XOR and the XNOR operation. That means the XOR operation of the A and B with the C is same as the XOR operation of the B and C with the A. And the same is also true for the XNOR operation. And in fact, in the previous video of the XOR and the XNOR gate, we have already seen that. That means these XOR and the XNOR gates are also associative. Now, if we talk about the NAND and the NOR gate, then they are commutative, but they are not associative. That means in the NAND and the NOR gate, if we interchange the two inputs, then also we will get the same result, but they are not associative. For example, for the NAND gate, the NAND operation of the A and B followed by the C is not the same as the NAND operation of the B and C followed by the A. Likewise, for the NOR gate also, the NOR operation on A and B followed by the C is not the same as the NOR operation of the B and C followed by the A. That means these NAND and NOR gates are commutative, but they are not associative. And this can be proved using the truth table. Alright, so now let's move to the next law, that is the distributive law. So as per this law, the AND operation of this A and the B or C is same as the OR operation of this A and B and the A and C. So basically, this law is very similar to our normal algebra, where the variable outside the bracket is multiplied with the each term in the bracket. So here, the variable outside the bracket gets ANDed with the each term inside the bracket. Now this law is also true for more than one variable. For example, the AND operation of this AB with the C or D is same as the OR operation of this ABC and the ABD. That means the variable outside the brackets gets ANDed with the each term inside the bracket. Or if we think other way around, then anything which is common in the both terms can also be taken outside as a common term. For example, this A plus AB is equal to A. So in this case, this A is common in both terms. So if you take this A outside, then we will have this A and 1 plus B. Now we know that 1 plus something is always equal to 1. That means this term will become 1. That means now we will have A dot 1 and that is equal to A. That means this A plus AB is equal to A. Similarly, the second distributive law is A plus BC is equal to A plus B and A plus C. So to prove that, let us take the RHS. So similar to our usual algebra, the each variable gets ANDed with the other variable. So in this case, we can write it as A dot A plus A dot C plus B dot A plus B dot C. Now we know that this A dot A or the AND operation of A and A is equal to A. And this B dot A can also be written as A dot B. That means we can write this expression as A plus AC plus AB plus BC. So in these first three terms, this A is common. So if we take this A outside, then we will have 1 plus C plus B. And this term will remain as it is. Now once again, we know that 1 plus something is always equal to 1. That means this is equal to 1. So we can write it as this A dot 1 plus BC. And we know that this A dot 1 is equal to A. That is equal to A plus BC. And that is equal to LHS. So that is the second distributive law. So using the same distributive laws, we can prove that this A dot A plus B is equal to A. Or in other words, the AND operation of the A with the A plus B is equal to A. So to prove that, let us take the LHS. So here, this A will get ANDed with the each term inside bracket. That means we can write this expression as A dot A plus A dot B. Now as we have seen earlier, this A dot A is equal to A. That means we can write this expression as A plus AB. And we have just seen that this A plus AB is equal to A. That means the A dot A plus B is equal to A. So this is how, using this Boolean laws, it is possible to minimize the Boolean expressions. So at the end, now let us look at the double negation. So we know that the complement of the A is equal to A bar. And if we once again take the complement of this A bar, then it will be equal to A double bar. So if A is equal to 1, then its complement A bar will be equal to 0. And once again, if we take the complement of this A bar, then it will be equal to 1. So if you see this A double bar, then it is same as the A. That means the complement of the A bar is same as the A. So in this way, we have covered most of the Boolean laws. Now the only thing which still remains is the De Morgan's theorem. So in the next video, we will also learn about the De Morgan's theorem. But I hope in this video, you learned about the different Boolean laws and its importance in the digital electronics. So if you have any question or suggestion, then do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe to the channel for more such videos.